Hello everyone, welcome back to Vastrakala by VS Creations. In our quest to recreate nature with needle and thread, here we are with yet another tutorial. I have opted to predominantly use the couching and its variation called Romanian couching for this. Just to add some variety, have sparingly used the fishbone stitch also. First, let's see the couching stitch that's been used for these petals. This is called as Romanian couching. This form of couching is useful for filling in large spaces in which a flat, indefinite background is required. To work this, bring the thread out and carry the thread across the space to be filled and take a small stitch with the thread above the needle and take small stitches along the line at regular intervals till the end of the laid thread, emerging in position for the next stitch. Here I'm using all the 6 strands of the embroidery floss. In embroidery, couching is a technique in which yarn or other materials are laid across the surface of the ground fabric and fastened in place with small stitches of the same or different yarn. The couching threads may be either of the same color as the laid threads or of a contrasting color. There is a similar stitch called Romanian stitch which can be used for filling shapes. But in that, only one small crossing stitch is taken in the center of the shape. Then we have the basic couching that has been used to depict the stem and the water here. To work this out, layer thread along the line of the design and with another thread tie it down at even intervals with a small stitch into the fabric. The tying stitch can be of contrasting color to the laid thread if desired. Keep the laying thread slightly loose and knotted at the back side so that while making the small tying stitches, it can be adjusted as per the design lines, especially in case of curved lines in the design. You can check out how the shapes have been brought out in this demonstration. Here again, I'm using all the 6 strands of the embroidery floss and using 2 shades of blue to get the water effect. As mentioned earlier, keep the laying threads slightly loose to achieve the curved design lines. There's another stitch called Bokhara couching which is very useful and ornamental in filling shapes of leaves and petals of flowers. You can check out the working of the same from an earlier tutorial from our Beginner's Guide to Embroidery series. The link for the same is provided in the description box. The next stitch is the fishbone stitch. Fishbone stitch is very useful for filling small shapes like flowers and petals. For making this, bring the thread out from the central line and make a sloping stitch to one of the outer design lines. And then from the underside of the design, take the thread to the other side and make a sloping stitch back to the central line. Continue in this sequence. Here in this case, I have used an open fishbone stitch. You can check out both the variations of fishbone stitch, that is the regular one and the open fishbone stitch from the tutorial on shape filling stitches. Hope you found this short tutorial helpful. Please consider giving a thumbs up and subscribing to this channel for more such creative tutorials. Don't forget to hit the bell icon to get notified on our future videos. See you all soon with another creative tutorial.